the name of YaHuWaH, the Most High. I praise the name of YaHuWaH Elohim, because his great and awesome name has gone forth to the four corners of the earth. And the fame of our Mighty One, our Elohim, has been recounted to us. And all the nations have indeed declared that his works are true, that his name is true, that he is the only Elohim, YaHuWaH Elohim. Though they have perverted his image and his likeness, and they have bowed themselves down to that which they have graven with their own hands, their own idols, and their own lusts. But YaHuWaH has told us that we cannot have any image or any likeness of that which is in the Shamayim, or that which is in the earth, and that which is under the earth. We will not bow down to them. We cannot serve them, because YaHuWaH Elohim is a territorial Elohim in our midst. YaHuWaH is zealous for his people, and he has told us no images, only the image of our Elohim. That is the only image which he has given. And how did he reveal himself? How did YaHuWaH Elohim reveal himself to the world? Through his word. And we know that the word of our Elohim is true. In the scriptures, if you will search them diligently, from the Torah, the law, to the prophets, the Nevi'im, and to the Brit HaMashiach, the renewed covenant writings, you will see the ongoing message that the name of YaHuWaH is the centerpiece of all the scriptures, and it is the most magnificent and excellent revelation that one could possibly ever receive, because the scriptures have revealed that all who call upon the name of YaHuWaH shall receive the redemption. They shall escape, as is quoted in YaHuWaH or Joel chapter 2, in Acts chapter 2, in Romans chapter 10. You will see this. And over and over and over, you see the theme in the Tehillim, in the Psalms, how David says that YaHuWaH saved him for his great name's sake. Hallelujah. The very first question that Moshe, who has been called Moses, asked the Most High when he encounters him at the burning bush, and the Malach YaHuWaH, the messenger YaHuWaH, answers to him and cries out to him from the burning bush. The very first question Moshe, who is called Moses, asks, he says, "When your people ask me what your name is, what shall I tell them?" He asks, "What is your name?" YaHuWaH Elohim responds through the Malach, the messenger, who is like a flame of fire within the burning bush. He responds very powerfully, "Haya, ahaya, asher, ahaya, I am that I am, I exist that I exist, I will be that I will be, the existing one, the self-existing one," by saying, "Ahaya, I exist. Asher, that, ahaya, I exist." He is telling us that he exists upon himself, and in his explanation of his great and awesome name, YaHuWaH, the term ahaya, I exist, appears two times. That should be noted, because it is giving us a beautiful picture of YaHuWaH and his likeness, his word, which was revealed to the prophets of old. And through their writings, and through their words, and their testimony, we have been given insight into the invisible Elohim, YaHuWaH Elohim, the Most High, the great and awesome Mighty One. His fame went out throughout all the lands, when he destroyed Mitzrayim, who it has been called Egypt, when his people, the Hebrew people, the Hebrew people, were under the persecution of the house of bondage, under the hand of Pharaoh, being a false idol, being a man, mighty one on the earth, thinking that he is like the Most High. And the house of bondage, a picture of slavery and sin. And YaHuWaH smote him, and he did this. He did this to Pharaoh. When you read in the scriptures, he says, I have raised you up so that I can make my name known in the earth. And indeed, he made his name known in the earth when he destroyed these nations, Mizraim and Babylon, and the list goes on and on, because our Elohim is just and he is righteous. And he sets up kings and he tears them down. YaHuWaH Elohim, there is none like him. He has said in his scriptures that we must call upon his name. That all who call upon his name shall be saved. They shall receive the redemption. They shall escape in the day of darkness that is coming upon the world in these latter times. And when we say Yikara, that word, Kara, means to proclaim and to preach and pronounce and profess the great and awesome name of YaHuWaH Elohim. And if we rightly divide the scriptures, the word of truth, we will go to the Tehillim and read also through the account there in the Psalms that YaHuWaH is near to all who call upon him. All who call upon him in truth. If you are going to call upon the name of the one who speaks like the multitude of many waters, if you are going to call upon the one who fashioned the earth and who hung the stars and who put the planets in their orbit and gave the sun for a light by day and the moon for a light by night, if you are going to call upon the one who formed mankind out of the dust of the earth, if you are going to invoke his name, you must do it in emet, which means truth. You must call his name sincerely. You must come before him in truth. He desires truth in the inward part. Hallelujah. So we must call upon his name in truth, and to call upon his name in truth, one must have a proper understanding of YaHuWaH and what his name really means. Because in his name is the great mystery of the four letters. When you take the four letters of YaHuWaH's name in the modern Hebrew, you will see they are called YaHuWaH. However, if you were to look up each one of these letters and their true phonetic pronunciation, they would be called YaHuWaH. And when you look up each one of these words, my friends, my brothers, my sisters, each letter is a word in the Ivrit, the Hebrew. And when you look them up, the letter Yad means hand. The letter ha or hey means to behold, and the wall means nail, and the ha on the end means to behold. So you literally have hand behold, nail behold, and that revelation of hand behold, nail behold remains true in the Paleo of Greek, the Paleo Hebrew. And when you go a little bit further back to the pictographic Hebrew, which was found in on Mount Sinai in Arabia and in Mizraim, the house of bondage, you will see that the YaHuWaH in the pictographic form literally shows the right hand of YaHuWaH. And next to the right hand of YaHuWaH, you see the likeness and the similitude of a man, and he is beholding, just as the word hey or ha means to behold. And he has his hands stretched up to the Shamayim. He is worshiping and acknowledging and calling upon and praising the Almighty Elohim YaHuWaH. At the right hand of the Father, the Abba in Shamayim, you see the similitude and form and image of a man. And these two letters are pronounced YAH. And you, my friends, have heard Hallelujah over and over, because hallelujah is a universal word. It is the same in all languages. And hallelujah means to praise Yah. And that means we must praise YaHuWaH. Yah is the shortened poetic form of YaHuWaH. You see Yah on the name of most of the prophets, such as Eliyah or Eliyahu, who has been called Elijah, Jeremiah or Jeremiahu, who has been called Jeremiah, Obadiah or Obadiah, which means servant of YaHuWaH. You have heard him called, you've heard all these names like Hezekiah, which is Hezekiahu. You hear these names, Isaiah, which is Yashayah or Yashayahu. All these names of the Nabi, the Nabim, the seers, the prophets of YaHuWaH Elohim reveal his name, the Father's name. And then when we look at the name of the Mashiach, the Messiah, Yahushua's name literally means YaHuWaH delivers, YaHuWaH saves. It is literally a combination of the name YaHuWaH and the word Yahshua, the passive participle of the root Yasha, which we see YaHuWaH and Yahshua throughout the scriptures, time and time again, being a picture of Yahushua's name. Hallelujah. Now, going back to YaHuWaH's name, we have the right hand, we have the man, hand behold. This is the short poetic form. You hear it in hallelujah, to praise YaHuWaH. People have been saying hallelujah, but do they know this revelation? Do they know that at the right hand of YaHuWaH, in his very name, is a picture and of the similitude of a man? And the very next letter, the wall being the nail, and we know if we take hand, behold, nail, we are talking about the piercing of the hand of Mashiach when the nails were nail driven into his palms when he was upon the timber. Hand, behold, nail, and we have behold, and you see the similitude of that man is alive and well, again, showing the very revelation of the resurrection. Yahushua says that he is the resurrection and the life. Hallelujah. Now, if we have a proper understanding of the name of YaHuWaH Elohim, if we understand that YaHuWaH saves with a mighty right arm, Yashayahu says in chapter 53, YaHuWaH, who has believed our report? And to whom was the arm of YaHuWaH revealed? For he, the arm of YaHuWaH, grew up before him as a tender plant. The arm of YaHuWaH has been revealed to mankind. Who has believed this report? That the arm of YaHuWaH would be revealed and grow up amongst the people, his brothers, as a tender plant. The arm of YaHuWaH became flesh. The arm of YaHuWaH is the Malach YaHuWaH who spoke to Moshe when he said, Ahaya Asher Ahaya, I am that I am, I exist that I exist. It was the Malach YaHuWaH who was like a flame of fire, and he spoke to the prophets of old. And this Malach YaHuWaH is the mighty right arm of YaHuWaH. He is the salvation of YaHuWaH. YaHuWaH delivers with a mighty right arm. You see this concept throughout the Torah, the prophets, the writings, the Brit Hadashah is the ongoing theme. We know that this very revelation of the mighty right hand of YaHuWaH, and at the mighty right hand of YaHuWaH, there being a man, and that man existed with YaHuWaH in the beginning, and that man would become flesh, that image, that likeness, the word of YaHuWaH would become flesh and go through the nail and be resurrected. This is all in YaHuWaH's name, and the name of the Son, Yahushua, says YaHuWaH saves, YaHuWaH delivers. The name of the Abba, who is in Shemayim, the Father, who is in the heavens, his name means a points to a picture of his deliverance, his salvation plan to redeem mankind to himself. It points to the Mashiach, the Messiah, and the name of the Ben, the Son of YaHuWaH, points to the Father, the Abba, who is in Shemaim, that says YaHuWaH saves. That is his name. That is what his name means. So when Yahushua prays and he says, Abinu, B'Shemayim, Yikadesh Shimcha, our Abba, who is in Shemayim, let your name be Kodesh. He is telling you that he magnifies the name of YaHuWaH, the Elohim of the prophets of old, that he worships his Abba, and his name means that he, that the Abba who is in Shemayim, saves and delivers. Hallelujah. Now, let's take this understanding of the name of YaHuWaH Elohim, and let's go over to Yohanan, John, chapter 1, and let us confirm the things that I've been saying to you. This, the purpose of this teaching is to take you on a journey into the Shemitic Brit Hadashah, what is called the New Covenant, the Renewed Covenant. If you look in the Aramaic versions of the Brit Hadashah from the Koboras Codex and the Peshitta and these various manuscripts, you go into them, you can tie the very words of the Aramaic back into the Hebrew original, the Abrit. And when you do this, you can go back into the Torah and the prophets of old, and you can see the ongoing themes by the ongoing use of the same words. You can tie these things in together. They have the same alphabet, Aramaic and Abrit, Hebrew. They don't have all the same words, but they have a lot of the same words. We say shalom in Abrit, in Hebrew. In Aramaic, they say shalomah. The word, we say Ruach HaKodesh in Abrit, in Hebrew. They say Ruka HaKodesha in Aramaic. We see the same ongoing concepts. So it is a beautiful resource that we have, because the Greek writings of the Brit Hadashah, they use words that are indeed pagan, and they use terminologies for the Most High that are basically names of other mighty ones. They use terms like Kyrios. Kyrios is used for all the pagan mighty ones. And they translate that Lord. They completely took Yahuwah's name out in many places. However, in the Septuagint, in the Greek Septuagint, the original Septuagint fragments all have Yahuwah's name in modern and Paleo-Hebrew. It's an ongoing trend throughout the first Septuagint to not translate his name. However, a little later, in the practice of these Greek scribes, they began to substitute that great and awesome name, YaHuWaH, and they began to put Kyrios in its place. And in the Latin versions of the Brit Hadashah, they even used the term Deus, which means Zeus, which is blasphemous beyond all imagination. The name of YaHuWaH is essential for salvation. The name of his son, Yahushua, must be professed and must be proclaimed. Let's go to the book of Yohanan, John chapter 1, verse 1. It reads, in an old familiar passage, in the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with Elohim, and the Word was Elohim. If we go into the Aramaic version of Yohanan, what we read here, the very first word is Bereshith. Bereshith is the very first line in the book that has been called Genesis, the very first page of our scriptures in chapter 1, verse 1, the very first word in all of scripture is Bereshith. And the word, the name Genesis is what people call that in English. However, in the Hebrew, when you look Genesis is Bereshit. So there is a revelation that is being told to us right here by Yahuchanan. Yahuchanan has been called John, and he is the beloved Talmid, the student, the disciplined one of Yahushua, the Messiah, HaMashiach. He is the very Talmid, the student of Yahushua, who received the Sefer, the book of Chazon, the revelation, in which he was caught up into the Shamayim, into the heavens, and he was given revelation of YaHuWaH and the day of YaHuWaH, the great and awesome Yom YaHuWaH that is coming. So the Talmid who received the book of Revelation is telling us that his master teacher is the word. Bereshit, in the beginning, was the, in the Aramaic says, Miltha. The equivalent to Miltha is the Hebrew word Debar. The word Debar means word. It means a manifestation. It also means a thing, some type of substance. The word Miltha also means manifestation, and it also means an image. So, in the beginning was a manifestation, not just a word, but a manifestation. So when you read in the books of the prophets, when you go to Ezekiel, for instance, or Yirmiyahu, Jeremiah, when you go to Yashiyahu or Isaiah, and you read, and it says the word came unto the prophet saying, it will read, the word of YaHuWaH came unto me saying, in the Hebrew there is no word of, it is strictly Dabar YaHuWaH, word YaHuWaH, manifestation YaHuWaH, and it came to him saying. So not just a word came, but a manifestation came. They saw YaHuWaH throughout the scriptures. However, there's a mystery, and I'm about to get into that, which the scriptures tell us no man has seen the Father. We're going to get into that in just a moment. But just let this sink in for a moment. That in the beginning, in Bereshit, in Genesis, in the very first line of scripture, is the Word. And the Word, the Dabar, the manifestation, the likeness, is with Elohim. And the Word, the Dabar, or Miltha, as is in the Aramaic, that the Miltha, the Dabar, was Elohim. So the Word is one with Elohim. The Word is Elohim. And it says, he was in Bereshit. Remember, he was in Genesis. He was in the beginning with Elohim. Without him, not even one came to be that came to be. In him was Chai, life. And the Chai, the life, was the light of men. This one came for a witness, to bear witness of the light, that all might believe through him. He was not that light, but that he might bear witness of that light. He was the true light, which enlightens every man coming into the world. He was in the world, and the world came to be through him. And the world did not know him. Hallelujah. If you think about this for a moment, it's very clear. The Word came to the earth, it became flesh, it dwelt among us. And when it did, the world did not know him. The Word was used, the Mashiach, the Messiah, the teacher, was used to create all things in the book of Bereshit, in Genesis, in chapter 1. He was used because he is the Word. And when we read in Bereshit, we see that Elohim creates through his Word. He speaks, and it is. That is how awesome YaHuWaH, our Elohim, is. Hallelujah. He was in the world, and the world came to be through him. It came to be through the Word. And the world did not know him. He came to his own. He went to the children of Yehuda. And he called out to the lost sheep of Yisrael. He came to his own, and his own did not receive him. But as many as received him, to them he gave the authority to become children of Elohim, B'nai Elohim, to those believing in his name. Believing in his name is the authority to be a child of Elohim. And what is the name of the Mashiach, the Messiah, that we see throughout all of the records of Scripture? It is Yahushua. Yahushua, which means YaHuWaH saves. To everyone who believes in Yahushua, the Mashiach, that believes that YaHuWaH is the Savior, to all those who believe this, He has given the authority to be children of Elohim, who were born not of blood, nor of desire of flesh, nor of the desire of men or man, but of Elohim. And the Dabar, the Word, the manifestation, became flesh and pitched His tent among us, and we saw His kabod, His esteem, kabod or esteem, as of an only brought forth of a Abba, of a Father, complete in favor and truth. Yahuwah bore witness of Him and cried out, saying, "This was He of whom I said, He who comes after me has come before me, because He was before me. But out of His completeness we all did receive, and favor upon favor. For the Torah was given through Moshe, through Moses. The favor and the truth came through Yahushua, Mashiach, the Messiah. No one," here is the great mystery, my friends, my brothers, my sisters, the Scripture says, "No one has ever seen Elohim, the only brought forth Ben, the Son, who is in the bosom of the Abba, He did declare." Hallelujah. So the Scripture says no one has seen Elohim, but they only brought forth from the Abba to declare. And this is the picture that we have. We know that when the Word came to the prophet saying, and it says, the Dabar YaHuWaH came to me saying, and they saw the manifestation of YaHuWaH, which we will get into in a moment, and prove that the Nabim, the prophets, saw the likeness and similitude of YaHuWaH Elohim. When they saw this picture of Elohim, they saw the Ben YaHuWaH, the Son of YaHuWaH, the brought forth one, the Word, the Malach, who became flesh. Now, what is interesting, how the Word became flesh. Remember this for a moment, and let's take your minds back into the Torah. And we read how Moshe, who was called Moses, how he received the writings, the laws, and the rulings, the Torah, the word Torah literally meaning instructions, teachings, and laws. And he received this from YaHuWaH Elohim, and he wrote this upon the skins of Kodesh, animals, of clean animals. And in the scroll of the Torah, which is Genesis, Exodus, Leviticus, Numbers, Deuteronomy, the first five books of Scriptures, this revelation of the hidden Elohim, the one who only those who were Kodesh would have a revelation of, only one, those who were set apart and sanctified unto Elohim, only they would receive the revelation of Him. When this revelation of the Torah was given, it was written upon skins. Now remember where it says that the Word became flesh? Let's look at the Torah scroll. The Torah scroll is the Word of Elohim. It is the Word of Torah. It is the Word of YaHuWaH Elohim. And it is written upon skin. It is written upon flesh. The word for flesh in Hebrew or Hebrew is bashar. And bashar, the word for flesh, is also the word for glad tidings, which has been called erroneously gospel. Gospel being a pagan origin, a combination of the two words, God and spell. And we do not use the name God, because God is the name of a demon and a devil of Babylon. Phonetically, if you search the Scriptures, you will see that it is indeed true. It is H1409 in your Strong's Concordance. Go look it up. And the word God means a fortune deity. So we don't use that name. We don't use blasphemous names. That blasphemous terminology is for the whore of Babylon and for the beast that she rides. Because on that beast is the names, the very names of blasphemy. A blasphemous name is a name that brings reproach to our Elohim. So we profess the name of YaHuWaH because of His Kodesh, His sanctified and set apart name, is the great revelation that the right arm of YaHuWaH, the right arm of YaHuWaH beside His right arm, is the image of a man, and that that man would become flesh, would go through the nails, the stake, and that He would resurrect, and that He would live again, and His resurrection would give all of life. And this is in the one name of the Father of YaHuWaH. And Yahushua, the Word, told us when He walked the earth that the greatest of the commands that were in the Torah, that again, were written on flesh, Bashar, that word Bashar meaning glad tidings, the Word became flesh, the Word became glad tidings, all there in the Scriptures, that the greatest law within all the Torah was Shema Yisrael, hear, listen, do Yisrael, YaHuWaH Eloheinu, YaHuWaH Echad, YaHuWaH our mighty one, YaHuWaH is one, and we should love YaHuWaH our Elohim with all of our heart and all of our being and all of our strength. And in the greatest commandment within this revelation of the glad tidings written upon the flesh, the Torah, within it, the greatest revelation is YaHuWaH Eloheinu, YaHuWaH Echad, YaHuWaH our mighty one, YaHuWaH is one. His name appears twice in the greatest commandment, and He lets us know, though His name appears twice, that He is one. He is Echad. He is united. Hallelujah. If you look in the Torah, you will see that Moshe was told by YaHuWaH Elohim to take the book of the witness of the Torah and to sprinkle it with blood, because the Word that became flesh must bleed for our redemption. His blood must be shed, because without the shedding of blood, there is no sanctification in the Scriptures. There is no forgiveness of sin. The shedding of blood of the Kodesh is required for atonement. And Yahushua, by His blood, the Word became flesh. That Torah scroll that was made flesh, that was sprinkled with the blood, He has once and for all received this crushing by the mighty right hand of YaHuWaH, that He may be resurrected and sit at the right hand of YaHuWaH Elohim on high. Now, let's go to the first revelation in all of the Torah and all of that Word that became flesh. Just like Yehoshua told us, He said, in the beginning was the Word. He says, Bereshit was the Word. He's telling the reader, the student, the Talmid, go to Bereshit. Go to the beginning. Go to Genesis. So let's go to the beginning. Let's go to the very first of the revelation that was given to the prophet Moshe. It says, in the beginning, Elohim created the heavens and the earth. Now, within this very verse in the English, there is something that is missing. There is something that the reader who is not a studier, those who are just giving the Scriptures a glance, they're obviously going to miss. It takes the Ruach HaKodesh, the wind and breath of YaHuWaH Elohim, to understand what I'm about to tell you. I'm about to show you that the Word was in the beginning. In the Hebrew, in the Abrit, it literally says, Barashit bara Elohim et hashamayim wa et ha'aretz, which has been translated, in the beginning, Elohim created the heavens and the earth. However, there are two places in the Hebrew that are completely left out. Two times the et is left out, the aleph and the tall, because it is not translated. It is not translated in the English because there is no equivalent. You see, aleph and tall has been said to be a designator for the subject of whatever word it appears next to. However, there is much more that the Alatal means. Because in the book of Chazon, the Revelation, remember Yehukan and John, who said in the beginning, was the Word, and the Word was with Elohim, and the Word was Elohim, he had the revelation. And in the revelation, he was told by Yahushua Mashiach, I am Aleph, and I am Tall. We read that in Aramaic. Now in the Greek, it says Alpha and Omega. Alpha and Omega. Yahushua didn't speak Greek. He came to his own did not receive him. He came for the lost sheep of Yisrael. He says so himself. Even Shaul says that when he was on the road to Damascus, Yahushua spoke to him in the Hebrew tongue, the Hebrew tongue. In the Greek, it even says Hebraeus. In the Aramaic, it says Abrit. So those who say that Yahushua spoke Aramaic, that's not what it says in the Aramaic. It says he spoke Hebrew. He spoke Abrit. So Yahushua said, I am Aleph and Tall, because again, the Aramaic and the Hebrew, they do have the same Aleph Beit. They are Shemitic languages. They are sister languages. They're a bridge for us to see. So in Aramaic and in Hebrew, when we see, we have the same letters, Aleph, Beit, Gimel, Dalet, Hey, Wal, Zion, Het, Tet, Yod, Kof, Lamed, Mem, Nun, Samek, Ayin, Pei, Sadi, Kuf, Resh, Shin, Tal. They are all the same. And it begins with Aleph and ends with Tal. Because the Aleph and Tal are used to create all words. They are the range of all letters. They are the formula for everything you see. All things that are seen and unseen were created by the word of YaHuWaH, and he created them to use these words. He put these words together and formed matter and things that are not even seen with the range of letters from Aleph to Tal. Hallelujah. So when we read Bereshith bara Elohim et, beside Elohim is the Aleph and the Tal. It is not just beside Elohim, it is literally connected, being a designator, again, as they say, that is what it means, but again, it means something so much more. But it is letting you know that the subject it is connected to is Elohim. So there we see in Bereshith is the Word, and the Word is with Elohim. Now Yehukanan lets you know that the Aleph Tal is Elohim. That is why in the book of Chazon, when you read in chapter 1, you will see Yahuwah Elohim says, I am Aleph, and I am Tal. And later, Yahushua HaMashiach, our Messiah, our Master, the image that became flesh, says, I am Aleph, and I am Tal, because Yahuwah Eloheinu, Yahuwah Achad, Yahuwah our Elohim, Yahuwah is one. He is united. Hallelujah. All right, so in the beginning, Bereshith bara Elohim. In the beginning, created Elohim. Aleph Tal, Hashamayim, the heavens. Wa Aleph Tal, the earth, Haaretz. Now let's go down to verse 26. Now I would advise you to read all of the verses previous before 26, because it tells you Yahuwah created by speaking. You know, constantly it will say, Wa Yamar, and spoke Elohim. And it will tell him, he will speak light be and light became. You know, he created the words of the world again with his words, right? So, but when you go to verse 26, this is the subject matter for this teaching. And Elohim said, let us, okay? Elohim said, let us make man in our image, according to our likeness, and let them rule over the fish of the sea, and over the birds of the shamayim, and over the livestock, and over all the earth, and over all the creeping creatures that creep on the ground. And Elohim created the man in his image. In the image of Elohim, he created him. Male and female, he created them. So, right here, Yahuwah Elohim, Elohim being the royal plural form of Eluah, which means mighty one. So, because it is plural, Elohim can mean mighty ones. However, when you rightly divide the word of truth, again, Yahuwah says that he is the only Elohim and that he is one. He is Achad. So the reason it's plural is because Yahuwah Elohim is infinite, and the Shamayim of the Shamayim cannot contain him, as the scriptures say through the words of the prophets. So he says, let us make man in our image. And who is he speaking to? He is speaking to the Ben Yahuwah, the son of Yahuwah, the image of Yahuwah, the likeness of Yahuwah. He says, let us make man in our image. Salamenu, sal, it comes from the word salama, salama being an image, according to our demuthnu, which means our demuth, our likeness, our pattern, our similitude. And let them rule over the fish of the sea and over the birds, the shamayim, and over the livestock, and over all the earth, and over all the creeping creatures that creep on the ground. And Elohim created the man in his image. In the image of Elohim, he created him. Male and female, he created them. The words salmah, which means image, and demuth, which means likeness or similitude or pattern or form, is very necessary in this study, because these words bridge a gap. They bring you into a direct revelation into the Brit Hadashah, into the renewed covenant writings, because these words appear in Aramaic. They are Hebrew words, but again, remember, Aramaic is a sister language. Greek is not a sister language, so we don't see these words used. We see alternative words, but these words here are Kodesh. They appear in the Ibrit, in the Hebrew, and they also appear in the Aramaic and in the Hebrew portions of the Brit Hadashah as well. And this is going to show you that the Mashiach is the mighty right arm of Yahuwah that was revealed, that grew among us as a tender plant, that he is the likeness and the similitude of the Abba who is in Shamayim, that no man has seen Elohim, but they only brought forth son to declare. Now, does that mean when he became flesh? No, not just when he became flesh. It means before he became flesh. It means after he became flesh. It means that he is, that he is, that he exists and exists. That he is the one who is and was and is to come. He went through that torture stake and he lives forevermore. He is the word of Yahuwah, the word, word meaning manifestation, the likeness, the similitude of Yahuwah. And this is another point that I want to make. When it says, let us make man in our image, of course, Yahuwah is speaking to his Ben, his son, let us make man in our image. That means that man, male and female, the design of the human body, the design, the form, the pattern, the similitude that you are made in, It transcends time and space, because the image, the likeness that we were made in, though we are made from the dust of the ground, we are made according to the pattern, the likeness, the similitude. Oh, Elohim, he made us in his own likeness, in his own similitude. And people talk about the vanity of the flesh, and they're constantly hung up on their flesh and the flesh of others, either coveting or lusting or mocking one or the other. But it is not about your flesh or their flesh or anyone's flesh, but Yahuwah Elohim's flesh, and the fact that his Ben became flesh, because Elohim, Yahuwah, is not a man. The Father Almighty is Ruachot. He is the Spirit. He is the Spirit, the Living One, the Ruach, the wind and breath. Hallelujah. When I say Ruach in the plural there, I mean that Yahuwah Elohim is infinite. He is the wind and breath of the Almighty. He is that he is. He exists that he exists. Hallelujah. That image of Yahuwah Elohim that the prophet saw became flesh. It is about Yahuwah's image. It is about his likeness. And Yahuwah Elohim, again, is Ruach. He is not flesh, but his mighty right arm, his Malach, the one who he saves through, his hand became flesh. His son became flesh. The Demuth Yahuwah, the likeness, the similitude, and the word of Yahuwah became flesh and tabernacled among us. Hallelujah. So, brothers and sisters, you are made in His image. You are made in His likeness. We are made in this way so that we represent the Abba in Shemayim. And if we do not properly represent Him in this earth, then we are blasphemous representations of His likeness. If we do not represent Him in the way that we carry ourselves, the word name in Abrit, the very word name is Shem, and Shem does not just mean a name phonetically, but a character. The character, if we do not walk in His Torah, we cannot properly live by the Ruach. If we cannot live by the Ruach, we cannot display His character, His name. We are made in His image. We are vehicles in the earth. That our physical bodies and the makeup of our beings and our minds and our thoughts, all these things is a picture, a pattern of Yahuwah Elohim. We are made in His likeness, in His image. Hallelujah. Now, let's go to the book of Yechezkel, Ezekiel. Hallelujah. The book of Yechezkel and the book of Ezekiel. And we're going to go to chapter 1. And we're going to start in verse 26. But before we start, let me just give you a summary of what has happened in chapter 1. Yechezkel has been given a revelation of Yahuwah's chariot. And in Yahuwah's chariot is led by four living creatures called cherubim. And the cherubim are connected, and they all each have four faces. And this is all a very important picture of things which are in the Shemayim, the Shemayim, the Shemayim. But upon all this, we read in verse 26, it says, "And above the expanse over their heads," talking about the heads of the cherubim, "was the likeness that they moved of a throne in appearance like a sapphire stone. And on the likeness of the throne was a likeness, a demuth, as the appearance of a man high above it. And from his appearance, and from the appearance of his waist and upward, I saw what looked like glowing metal, with the appearance of fire all around within it. And from the appearance of his waist and downward, I saw what looked like fire and brightness all around, as the appearance of a rainbow in a cloud on a rainy yom or day. So was the appearance of the brightness all around. This was the appearance of the demuth, of the kabod, the esteem of Yahuwah, the kabod Yahuwah. And when I saw it, I fell on my face, and I heard a voice of one speaking." You see, when it tells you here that it says, "And from his appearance of his waist," it gives you an appearance of his waist and downward, and how it looks like fire and brightness all around. And it tells you in verse 26, it says, "And the likeness of the throne, and on the likeness of the throne was the likeness as the appearance of a man," the demuth of the appearance of a man. This demuth that is the appearance of a man was the demuth, the image, the likeness that Adam, the first man, was formed out of the earth of. He was formed in this likeness. He was formed in this image. So when Yechezkel sees it, he identifies this as the demuth. This is the likeness. This is the image of a man. It has the same form. It has the same similitude. It has the same pattern of a man. And then he says that this was the appearance of the demuth of the kabod Yahuwah. "And when I saw it, I fell on my face." And what did he do? He heard. The word for here is Shema, the greatest of the commandments. Remember, Yahushua said, "Shema Yisrael." Here, listen to Yisrael. Yahuwah Eloheinu, Yahuwah Chad. Yahuwah our mighty one, Yahuwah is one. Yechezkel, Ezekiel, he sees the appearance of the demuth, the likeness, the similitude of Yahuwah. The kabod Yahuwah, he identifies him as the esteem of Yahuwah. So we know that the word, the manifestation, the demuth, the Mashiach, is the esteem, the kabod Yahuwah. Hallelujah. And it says that he fell on his face and he heard the voice of one speaking. And we know when we read other places in Scripture that the voice of that one is like the sound of a crowd, like the noise of a multitude, like the sound of many waters. Hallelujah. We know that Yahuwah Elohim is the Elohim of Elohim. He is the mighty one of mighty ones, the Melech HaMelechim. He is the King of Kings, the Sovereign of all Sovereigns. Hallelujah. And Ezekiel was given the privilege to see the demuth of his throne, the likeness of his throne, and the demuth of the appearance of a man who rode upon it. And that demuth, that image, that likeness, was the Kabod Yahuwah, the Sting Yahuwah. Hallelujah. By saying demuth Yahuwah, it is letting you know that this is not the fullness. Though this is the fullness, don't misunderstand me. What I mean here is that though this is YaHuWaH Elohim, this is not all of YaHuWaH Elohim. Because when we rightly divide the scriptures, the word of truth, it tells us that YaHuWaH Elohim, that the Shemayim, the heavens, cannot contain his esteem, his kavod. It cannot contain him. So of course, this likeness and this image, the likeness and the image of a man, that is the Demuth Yahuwah. There is more to Yahuwah than just this that appeared to Ezekiel. Yahuwah is infinite, yet he manifests. And in his manifestation, he speaks. Because the word of Yahuwah, the Dabar Yahuwah, came unto Ezekiel. And when it came unto Ezekiel, he spoke and he revealed many truths. Now let's go to chapter 8 of Ezekiel. In chapter 8, we're going to see the same type of experience that transpires. In verse 1, it says, "And it came to be in the sixth year, the sixth month, on the fifth of the new moon, as I sat in my house with the elders of Yahudah sitting before me, that the hand, the Yad, which is the word for the first letter of Yahuwah's name, YaHuWaH, hand behold, nail behold, the Yad of the Master, Yahuwah, fell upon me there." So the Yad of Adon, Yahuwah, fell upon him. And the hand of Yahuwah is the revelation of Yahuwah. It is the salvation of Yahuwah. Again, through the Tehillim, the Psalms, we read, David says that Yahuwah saves with a mighty right hand. We know in the Song of Moshe that Yahuwah delivered with a mighty right hand over and over and over. We see that Yahuwah saves with a mighty right hand as an ongoing theme. And here it says that the hand of the Master Yahuwah fell upon me there. And I looked and saw a likeness, a demuth, like the appearance of fire from his waist and downward. The appearance was like fire. And from his waist and upward, the appearance of brightness like glowing metal. And he stretched out the demuth, the form of a hand, and took me by a lock of my hair. And the Ruach lifted me, the wind and breath, the spirit lifted me up between the Ha'aretz, the earth, and Shamayim, the heavens, and brought me in the visions of Elohim to Yerushalayim, to the door of the north gate of the inner court, where the seat of the image of jealousy was, which causes jealousy. Why does the image of jealousy cause jealousy? Because YaHuWaH Elohim is the living one. And when we create things of stone, or images of wood, or lust of flesh, and all these various things, we mold these things, we make these things, we bow down to them, we pray to them, we deny the living one, and we worship the vanity of our own mind. Yahuwah said that we do not make for ourselves any image, any likeness in the heavens above, the earth beneath, the waters beneath the earth. We don't bow down to them nor serve them. We don't, but yet we see when the Yad of Yahuwah, the hand of Yahuwah, took Ezekiel into visions of Elohim, he took him to Yerushalayim. The people began to worship the image of jealousy. The image of jealousy was the image of the mighty one, the so-called mighty one, Baal, or Baal, which means Lord. And the very word Lord has covered up Yahuwah's name 7,000 times or more in the scriptures. Over and over and over. People call him Lord, they call him God, God being another name of Baal, of Baal. We see Baal God in the scriptures in the book of Yahshua. In the book of Joshua, YaHuWaH is the name of Joshua. When we look up and we see Baal God, we see all these things. So we know that this ongoing trend of setting up an image, it goes way back. It goes way back. And man gave over the authority to the serpent in the garden. That's the word serpent being the hash, a whisperer. And that whisperer, remember YaHuWaH made us in his image and his likeness, and we were to subdue the animals, to subdue the earth. And yet, in the beginning, in Bereshith, man hands over the right of subduing the earth and the animals of it by listening to the first of all, Adam listened to his wife, Hawa listened to the serpent. And they were deceived to partake of the knowledge of what was good and what was evil, what was told and what was evil. And at this moment, the sin crept into mankind and his flesh. Now he is in a battle with himself. Now, man reaches for Elohim. That is why even atheists have these satellites that face the Shamayim, the heavens, the space, the expanse, and they're trying to find intelligent life out there. Yes, there's intelligent life out there. YaHuWaH Elohim is out there, and he's all around because the Shamayim of Shamayim cannot contain him. And he is the living one. So when people make these images, these false images, if we read in the Torah, when Moshe received the Ten Commands on Mount Sinai, immediately when he went down the mountain, the people had made for themselves a molten calf. And that calf worship goes all the way back to Baal. And Baal being Jupiter, who is Zeus, the abomination of desolation, the false image that the people set up in their minds. That is why they worship these graven images and the images they see in the stained glass. All these things they created and made for themselves. But YaHuWaH Elohim is territorial. So we must go through his image, the likeness he has set up, his word, and his word is true. Hallelujah. Now, let's go to the book of Ibrahim in Hebrews. In the book of Ibrahim in Hebrews, we're going to read in chapter 1. Hallelujah. In Hebrews chapter 1, verse 1, it reads, Elohim, having of old spoken in many portions, in many ways, to the fathers by the prophets, has in these last showings spoken to us by the Son, whom he has appointed heir of all, through whom he also made the ages, who being the brightness of the kabod of the esteem and the exact representation of his substance, and sustaining all by the word, by the dabar, the word became flesh, remember this, of his power, having made a cleansing of our sins through himself, sat down at the right hand of the greatness on high. And this is quoted from Tehillim 110 verse 1, Psalm 110 verse 1, where YaHuWaH says to my master, come sit at my right hand until I make your enemies a footstool for your feet. Hallelujah. And again, we know that Mashiach is at the right hand of YaHuWaH in the name of YaHuWaH. And it says, remember, it says, this is the brightness of the kabod. Remember that word kabod, esteem? When Ezekiel, saw the Demuth YaHuWaH, he says, this was the likeness of the kabod YaHuWaH, the esteem of YaHuWaH. Hallelujah. Now when it says that Elohim, having of old spoken in many portions, in many Demuth, in the likeness many times, and many ways to the fathers by the prophets, by the seers, has in these last y'all spoken to us by the Son, whom he has appointed heir of all, through whom he also made the ages, because again, YaHuWaH spoke, and all was created. So he used the word is Mashiach, the word is Messiah, the word became flesh, who being the brightness of the esteem, the brightness of the kabod, and the exact representation, the word representation is Demuth. A lot of translations even say the exact image, the exact likeness, the exact representation of his substance. So he is the exact Demuth. He is the Demuth, the image, the likeness that Adam the man was first made in, because this is the image that YaHuWah said, let us make man in our image, according to our demuth, according to our likeness. Okay? So we see the word demuth in many forms, the word image, salma. Salma is the word that is used there. So salma is used for the exact representation, not demuth. The word demuth is used when it says that he spoke in many portions. So the word salma, that word salma, which is image, and the word demuth, which is likeness, when it says, let us make man in our image, and our salma, according to our likeness, our demuth, it says that Yahushua is both in the book of Ibrahim, in the first three verses of chapter 1. The revelation is that Elohim spoke in many, many times through the demuth, and that he is the exact salma, the exact representation of his substance. Now, in the Aramaic, it says it uses the same words. So we have a double testimony of the Hebrew, book of Hebrews, from Sebastian Musser's Matithyahu text in the appendix. We also take it back to the Kabbalist Codex of the Aramaic, and we see clearly that salma is used when it says he is the exact image, he is the exact. So if he is the exact image, you know that he is the image that Elohim said, let us make man in. So see how the Aramaic and the Hebrew ties itself back, shows us what is really being said to those who want to deny that Yahushua is the image of Elohim. There's no way. There's no way to deny it. It is a core teaching. This is the Bashar. This is the true told news. This is the excellent message of the reign of Elohim. This is, hallelujah, that the Word became flesh and tabernacled amongst us. Now, when it says that Elohim, having appeared in many times and in many forms, and in the Demuth, many times to the fathers by the prophets, let's look at other situations now. Yeah, Ezekiel saw the appearance of the likeness of a man, said it was the Demuth of the esteem, the likeness of the Kabod YaHuWah. Now let's go to Yashiyahu, Isaiah chapter 6, and read his account and see what Yashiyahu says concerning this matter. It says in chapter 6, verse 1, in the year that Sovereign Uzziyahu died, I saw YaHuWah sitting on a throne. Does this sound familiar? Ezekiel saw YaHuWah sitting on a throne. Yashiyahu saw YaHuWah sitting on the throne. Now do you understand when Yahushua says that no man has seen Elohim? This says, I saw YaHuWaH. I saw YaHuWah, the Abba, the Father. The scriptures say, no man has seen the Father, the only brought forth Ben, the only brought forth Son to declare. It was the Word that declared. It was that they moved the kabod, the likeness and the esteem of YaHuWah, whom he saw. I said, I saw YaHuWah sitting on a throne high and lifted up, and the train of his robe filled the hekal. Above it stood seraphim. Each one had six wings. With two he covered his face. With two he covered his feet. And with two he flew. And one cried to another and said, Kodesh, 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 set apart, set apart, set apart is YaHuWah of hosts. All the earth is filled with his kabod, his esteem. And the posts of the door were shaken by the voice, by the words of him who cried out, and the house was filled with smoke. And I said, woe to me, for I am undone, because I am a man of unclean lips, and I dwell in the midst of a people of unclean lips. For my eyes have seen the Sovereign, the Melech, YaHuWah Sabaoth, YaHuWah of the armies, YaHuWah of hosts. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. All right. Now, let's go over and look at Abraham. Abraham, the patriarch, the father of many nations, the father of the great nation, Yisrael, and the tribes of Yisrael, the 12 tribes of YaHuWah Elohim, in Bereshith, Genesis. Remember, in Bereshith was the word. Bereshith is the revelation. We need to go to Bereshith. Let's go to Bereshith, Genesis chapter 18. And we'll see Abraham's account. In chapter 18, verse 1, it says, and YaHuWah appeared to him by the trees of Mamre while he was sitting in the tent door in the heat of the yom of the day. So he lifted his eyes and looked and saw three men standing opposite him. And when he saw them, he ran from the tent door to meet them and bowed himself to the ground and said, YaHuWaH, if I have found favor in your eyes, please do not pass your servant by. And you should continue reading this encounter that Abraham has with YaHuWaH. Many people try to say that the three men were YaHuWaH, but this is what the scripture says further. Let's go on down to verse 22. It says, so the men, remember the three men? So the men turned away from there and went towards Sodom, but YaHuWaH still stood before Abraham. Hallelujah. So YaHuWaH appeared to Abraham. YaHuWaH appeared to Yitzhak. YaHuWaH appeared to Yaakov, whose name Yisrael. He appeared to his servants, the prophets, in many forms, in many demuth. When I say forms, that just means many times, plural, because YaHuWaH is infinite, because he appeared over and over and over. He is infinite. And YaHuWaH manifests through his word. And he spoke over and over to the prophets. The word of YaHuWaH came unto them saying. Now let's go to the Brit Hadashah, to the Renewed Covenant writings. We'll go to Colossians. We'll go to Colossians chapter 1. Hallelujah. The word of YaHuWaH is like living waters. It gives us, YaHuWaH gives us the revelation, and we drink upon his word. It is like bread of life. We eat upon his word. Let's go to Colossians chapter 1, and we're going to start in verse 12. Giving todah, giving thanks to the Abba, who has made us fit to share in the inheritance of the Kodesh ones, the set apart ones, in the light, who has delivered us from the authority of darkness and transferred us into the reign of the Son, the Ben of his love, in whom we have redemption through his blood, the forgiveness of sins, who is the Demuth, who is the likeness of the invisible Elohim, the firstborn of all creation. Because in him were created all that are in the Shemayim and all that are on earth, visible and invisible, whether thrones or rulerships or principalities or authorities. All have been created through him and for him, and he is before all, and in him all hold together, and he is the head of the body, the assembly, who is the beginning, the firstborn from the dead, that he might become the one who is first in all, because in him all the completeness was well pleased to dwell, and through him to completely restore to favor all unto himself, whether on earth or in the Shemayim or in the heavens, having made shalom or peace through the blood of his stake. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. This shows us the very picture of the Tov news of the Bashar, that the right of hand of YaHuWaH Elohim is a likeness and similitude who was in the beginning, the image. It says right here that Yahushua is the likeness that they moved of the invisible Elohim, the firstborn of all creation. That settles it. There's no more need for any more verses because this clearly sums it up. But I'm going to bring you more because the whole book of scripture gives us this revelation that the Ben YaHuWaH, the Demuth YaHuWaH, the image and likeness of YaHuWaH, is the Mashiach. It is the Messiah. The Messiah became flesh, went through the torture stake, resurrected, sits at the right hand of YaHuWaH Elohim. He is the son of the Abba, the son of YaHuWaH Elohim, the Father. Because of him were created all that are in the Shemayim, because he is the Word. Remember, YaHuWaH created the Shemayim by his word, and all that are on the earth. He created all that are on the earth by his word, by Yahushua, who became flesh. Hallelujah. But before he became flesh, he was known as YaHuWaH. He was known as the Demuth YaHuWaH, the Kabod YaHuWaH, the Yad YaHuWaH, the hand of YaHuWaH, the Malach YaHuWaH, the messenger YaHuWaH. Hallelujah. And all the patriarchs of old had a revelation, hallelujah, of the image and likeness. They proclaimed the Mashiach, the Master, the Messiah, hallelujah. All right, so it says again that he is before all, and in him all hold together. He is the head of the body, the assembly, who is the beginning, the firstborn from the dead, because he went through the state, and he might become the one who is first in all, because in him all the completeness was well pleased to dwell, and through him to completely restore to favor all unto himself, whether on the earth or in the Shemaim, having made shalom, having made peace through the blood of his stake. He made shalom through going through that nail, going through the wall. Hallelujah. He was restored through the resurrection. The resurrection is key to the understanding of the Demuth YaHuWaH, the image and likeness of YaHuWaH Elohim. Hallelujah. Now, let us go to Philippians chapter 2. And we'll start in verse 5. For let this mind be in you, which was also in Mashiach, Messiah Yahushua, who being in the Demuth Elohim, the image of Elohim, the form of Elohim, the Demuth Elohim, the pattern of Elohim, did not regard equality with Elohim a matter to be grasped, but emptied himself, taking the form, the Demuth, of a servant, and came to be in the likeness of men. It clearly tells you Yahushua existed before as the Demuth Elohim, the image of Elohim. So when Ezekiel, again, when he saw the Demuth, the kabod of a man, the Demuth, the likeness and kabod of Yahuwah Elohim, who was he seeing? He was seeing the only brought forth son who did declare. Yahushua was like the veil that was in the Torah between the Kodesh place, the sanctified place, and the most sanctified place, the Kodesh Kodeshim, where the Ark of the Covenant was, and where Yahuwah himself would speak and manifest. Only the high priest, the Kohen Habadah, could go beyond the veil, and Yahushua is the high priest in the Shamayim at the right hand of Yahuwah Elohim. It is his job to go between the Kerubim and to behold the face of the Abba. He has declared him. Hallelujah. It is Yahushua. It is the Ben. It is the Kabod Yahuwah who does declare. It is the Demuth Yahuwah who does declare. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. And remember that word veil is Bashar for flesh, because the veil is made of flesh. So that was glad tidings. And when that flesh tore, it was letting you know. When the veil tore, it was letting you know that Yahushua had been torn. That the word that was made flesh was torn. But it was restored again. Hallelujah. The image and likeness of Yahuwah Elohim. Because now it has received its former esteem and sits at the right hand of Yahuwah Elohim. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. All right, so let's keep on reading. It says, for let this mind be in you, which was also Messiah Yahushua, who being in the Demuth Elohim, the form of Elohim, did not regard equality with Elohim a matter to be grasped, but emptied himself, taking the Demuth of a servant, and came to be in the likeness of men. And having been found in a fashion as a man, he humbled himself and became obedient unto death, death even of a stake. Elohim, therefore, has highly exalted him and given him the name which is above every name. Now, Yahushua means Yahuwah saves, Yahuwah delivers. Joshua, the son of Nun, had this name. Yahushua, the son of Zadok, all these different men had the name of Yahushua in scriptures, and even in the Brit Hadashah, you see many men have this name, the name Yahushua. But the name that is above all names is the Father's name, because Yahushua said, I came in my Father's name, and you did not receive him. He said, many great works I have done in my Father's name. Hallelujah. He said, I made your name revealed to my brothers, talking about the Abba and the Shemayim. When he taught us how to pray, he said, our Abba who is in the Shemayim, Kodesh is your name, set apart is your name. His name is above all names. Yahushua said that the Abba was greater than he, hallelujah, that he is mightier than he. But the Father has given all to the Son, hallelujah. So, it says that he has given him the name which is above every name. Yahushua has inherited the name of Yahuwah. He has inherited the name of his father. This is a common practice in all cultures, that a father leaves for his son a name and gives for his son a name. Hallelujah. Yahuwah has bestowed the great and awesome name of YaHuWaH, and behold, now behold, upon his son. And remember the Torah, the Kohen Hagadol, the high priest, wears upon his head the very inscription and engraving that says, Kodesh le Yahuwah, sanctified unto Yahuwah. Hallelujah. So we know that Yahushua is the high priest in the Shamayim in the heavens. He has inherited the name above all names, that this name is upon his head. He has been given this by his Abba in the Shamayim. He has inherited the name above all names. And then it says that at the name of Yahushua, every knee should bow, of those in Shamayim, and those on the earth, and those under the earth, and every tongue should confess that Yahushua, Messiah, is master to the kabod of Elohim the Abba, to the esteem. Remember that word kabod? That when Ezekiel saw the image and likeness of Yahuwah, it says that he saw the demuth, the image, the likeness of the kabod, the esteem of Yahuwah. Well, now let's go into the Aramaic with this verse, and we will see that the very word Mar-Yah, which means Master Yah, that they use to replace Yahuwah's name appears for Master. Not just Mari, but Mar-Yah. And Mar-Yah, when you look it up in any lexicon of Aramaic, it'll tell you that Mar-Yah is used to replace YaHuWaH, YaHuWaH, the name of Yahuwah. Everywhere it appears. So when it appears, it says that Yahushua, we must profess Yahushua, that Yahuwah delivers, we must profess the Mashiach, that at the name of Yahushua, every knee should bow, of those in Shamayim, of those in the heavens, and those on earth, and those under the earth, and every tongue should confess that Yahushua, Mashiach, Messiah, is Mar-Yah, that he is Master Yah, that he is Yahuwah, to the kabod of Elohim, to the esteem of Elohim, the Abba, because he is the kabod of Elohim. He is the kabod Yahuwah. But he has inherited the name above every name. Yahushua inherited the name of every name. We must profess Yahushua. We profess that Yahushua is Yahuwah to the kabod, to the esteem of Yahuwah, because he is the kabod Yahuwah. He is the likeness of the kabod Yahuwah throughout the scriptures. The Mashiach. Hallelujah. So, now, let's go to the book of the dream of Hebrews once again, and let's look more at this role, the role of the high priest, the Kohen HaGadol, which Yahushua has. And let's go to Hebrews, to a dream, chapter 5 and verse 6. It says, as he also says in another place, you are a priest forever according to the order of Melchizedek, which means the king or sovereign of righteousness. This is talking about Tehillim 110, and it's in verse 4, where Yahuwah said to my master, come sit at my right hand, so I'll make your enemies a footstool for your feet. Later he says in verse 4 that you are a priest forever, a Kohen forever, after the order of Melchizedek. Now the word order, after the order, is demuth. It is demuth in the Aramaic, it is demuth in the Hebrew. It means after the form, after the likeness of Melchizedek. He will be the king of righteousness. Melchizedek was also the sovereign of Shalom, the sovereign of Salem. So we know that Yahushua is after this order, an order that precedes the Levitical priesthood, which precedes the very concept of the children of Levi. It says, who in the yomes of his flesh, when he had offered up prayers and petitions with strong crying and tears to him, who was able to save him from death, and was heard because of his reverent fear, though being a son, he learned obedience by what he suffered, and having been perfected, he became the causer of everlasting deliverance to all those obeying him. So we must obey the Mashiach. Hallelujah. And it says, having been designated by Elohim, a Kohen HaGadol, a high priest, according to the order of Melchizedek. Hallelujah. So there's so much more in the book of Ibrahim about the Melchizedek, the king, the sovereign of righteousness, who Yahushua is a form of, an image, a likeness of. But Yahushua, again, he wears the crown as high priest. After the order of Melchizedek, he wears the name of Yahuwah his Elohim. Hallelujah. Now let's go to chapter 9, verse 19. In chapter 9, we're going to start in verse 19. It says, "For when according to Torah, every command had been spoken by Moshe to all the people, he took the blood of calves and goats with water and scarlet wool and hyssop and sprinkled both the book, the sefer, which is the Torah, the book of the Torah, itself and all the people." So he sprinkled the Torah, the law, the word that was written on flesh, the word that was written on Bashar, Bashar meaning glad tidings, and flesh. He sprinkled the Torah scroll and the people with blood. And he said, "This is the blood of the covenant which Elohim commanded you." And in the same way, he sprinkled with blood both the tent and all the vessels of the service. And according to Torah, almost all is cleansed with blood, and without shedding of blood, there is no forgiveness. It was necessary then that the copies, the demuth, the likeness of the heavenly ones, that which is in Shemayim, should be cleansed with these. But the heavenly ones, those which are Shemayim, themselves with better slaughter offerings than these. So not just the bulls and goats, but of the Mashiach himself, the word itself, the blood of the word. Hallelujah. For Mashiach has not entered into the Kodesh place, the set apart place made by hand. Figures of the true, demuth of the true, the likeness of what is true, because what is true is in the Shemayim. So when Yahuwah told Moshe to have the images of Kerubim made for the Ark of the Covenant, where he would manifest. This was the images of what is true, because in Ezekiel there are the Kerubim that Yahuwah, when he sits upon his throne, there are the Kerubim that lead the throne, that carry the wheel within the wheel, that carry the throne all around. Hallelujah. So this was the image and the likeness. What Moshe received was the image and likeness of the true, which is in Shemayim. So it's necessary that the copies of the heavenly ones, those which are in Shemayim, should be cleansed with these, but the heavenly ones themselves with better slaughter offerings than these. For Mashiach has not entered into the Kodesh place, the set apart place made by hand, figures of the true, but into the Shemayim itself. He's gone into the Shemayim itself, now to appear in the presence of Elohim on our behalf. Not that he should offer himself often, as the high priest enters into the Kodesh place year by year. The Kohen Gadol in the scriptures always on the Yom HaKippurim, the Yom of Atonements. He went before the Kodesh place year by year. For if so, he would have had to suffer often since the foundation of the world. But now, he has appeared once for all at the end of the ages to put away sin by the offering of himself. And as it awaits men to die once, and after this the judgment, so also the Mashiach, having been offered once to bear the sins of many, shall appear a second time apart from sin to those waiting for him unto deliverance. Hallelujah. Now let's go to chapter 8 of Devarim, chapter 8, starting in verse 1. It says, "Now the summary of what we are saying is, we have such a Kohen HaGadol, such a high priest, who is seated at the right hand of the throne of the greatness in the Shemayim." Remember, Yod-Haz, the mighty right hand and the likeness and image of a man. "And who serves in the set apart of the Kodesh place and of the true tent which Yahuwah set up and not man. For every Kohen HaGadol, every high priest is appointed to offer both gifts and slaughters. So it was also necessary for this one to have somewhat to offer. For if indeed we were on earth, he would not be high priest, he would not be a priest, since there are priests, Kohanim, who offer the gifts according to the Torah, who serve a copy and a shadow of the heavenly, what is in the Shemayim, as Moshe was warned when he was about to make the tent, for he said, 'See that you make all according to the pattern shown on the mountain.'" The word pattern is demuth in the Aramaic. So the word pattern again, what Moshe was given, all the utensils and all the things that were in the Kodesh place, in the Mishkan, and the tent, in the wilderness, and in the house of Yahuwah that would later be made by King Shlomo, that all these that were inside the Kerubim and all these utensils and all these things were all a picture, they were all a likeness, they were all a demuth of what was to come. Even the high priest himself was a demuth of Yahushua, Hallelujah. He was an image, a likeness. He was an example of Yahushua HaMashiach. Hallelujah. So all these things are according to a pattern which does exist. Yahuwah has a throne. There are cherubim that are around his throne. There are 24 elders according to the book of Chazon, the Revelation. Hallelujah. And there are multitudes and multitudes which worship him and serve him because he is called Yahuwah Sabaoth, Yahuwah of the armies. He has messengers, thousands and thousands and thousands and millions of messengers. He is Yahuwah Sabaoth, Yahuwah of hosts. Hallelujah. He is the commander of all the malachim, the cherubim, the seraphim, all the living beings which are in Shamayim. Hallelujah. Alright, so, and he was also commander of all things, you know, but Yahuwah Elohim, he has all this esteem in the Shamayim, of the Shamayim, where his demuth appears. Hallelujah. Now we're going to go back to Philippians, and we're going to start in chapter 3 this time. So Philippians chapter 3, we'll start in verse 13. And it reads, "Brothers, I do not count myself to have laid hold of it yet, but only this, forgetting what is behind and reaching out for what lies ahead. I press on toward the goal for the prize of the high calling of Elohim and Mashiach Yahushua. As many then as are perfect should have this mind. And if you think differently in any respect, Elohim shall also reveal this to you. But to what we have already attained, walk by the same rule, be of the same mind, become joint imitators of me, brothers, and look at those who so walk, as you have us for a demuth, you have us for a pattern. For many of whom I have often told you, and now say to you, even weeping, walk as enemies of the stake of Mashiach. Their end is destruction, their mighty one is their stomach, and their esteem is in their shame. They mind the earthly. For our citizenship is in the Shamayim, in the heavens, in which we also eagerly wait for the Savior, the Master Yahushua Mashiach, who shall change our lowly body to be conformed to his esteemed body, his body of kabod, according to the working by which he is able to even bring all under his control. We are not citizens of the earth any longer. We are citizens of the Shamayim. Our king, our high priest, is in the Shamayim, and he bears the image and likeness. He is resurrected and bears the image and likeness of esteem. And it says here that we too shall receive a body of kabod. We too shall be a part of Yahuwah's reign. This Yahushua said that in the resurrection, we are as the malachim, as the messengers. Hallelujah. But he says that you have us for a demuth, you have us for a pattern. So imitate us and those who so walk, because you have us for a pattern, you have us for a demuth. And brothers and sisters, this is the high calling for you. You are to achieve and to be a pattern for those who are coming into the belief, to walk in such a way and to guard the covenant, to be a pattern and be a demuth. You are to walk in the pattern and image and likeness of Mashiach. You are to govern your life according to his ways, according to his principles. And you are to be like Mashiach on the earth as a picture, as an example, as a pattern to those who are coming into the belief. This is what we aspire for. This is our motivation in life, to be like Mashiach, to walk in his ways and to guard his commandments and to be a pattern. Because as we are moving on this narrow path, and we are walking on this journey, each step and every step is one more step toward the reign of Elohim, toward his coming, towards the Yom, the day of the resurrection, in which those who are dead shall arise and those who are alive shall receive new bodies and be with the Mashiach in his coming. We will have esteemed bodies. That is the picture of the resurrection. And the resurrection is a revelation in Yahuwah Elohim's name, YaHuWaH, hallelujah. So we are to be as a picture. Now let's go to the book of Romans. Romans chapter 8. Romans chapter 8, verse 29. And it reads, because those whom he knew beforehand, he also ordained beforehand to be conformed to the demuth, to the likeness of his ben, of his son, for him to be the firstborn among many brothers. And whom he ordained beforehand, these he also called. And whom he called, these he also declared right. And whom he declared right, these he also esteemed or gave kabod to. What then shall we say to this? If Elohim is for us, who is against us? So YaHuWaH knew us beforehand, and he chose us beforehand to be transformed into the demuth of his son. The demuth of his son is the demuth of YaHuWaH Elohim, is the likeness and image of YaHuWaH Elohim. We are made in his image. We are made in his likeness. We are like vehicles on the earth for his ruach, his wind, and his breath to operate through, to speak through, to share with the earth his love and kindness, and also the word of his judgments, and the words of his Torah, and the words of his truth, and the words of his Nevi'im. Because the word of YaHuWaH Elohim came, and it spoke, and it manifested, and it gave us the revelation. And now it is like fire in our bones, as Yirmiyahu said, when he thought to stop speaking in the name of YaHuWaH Elohim, it says that he was helpless because it was like fire in his bones. And remember, when they saw the image of YaHuWaH Elohim, that his waist and upward were like fire, his waist and downward were like fire. Hallelujah. Remember when Moses heard the Malach speaking in the burning bush, that the Malach was like fire. Hallelujah. And he declared, Hayah, Sher Hayah, I am that I am. He declared, YaHuWaH, the four letters, YaHuWaH. He declared the revelation. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. So, we are to walk in his ways, to imitate him, to be a pattern for people on the earth, because we are all on this journey moving towards the judgment of YaHuWaH, in which Yahushua HaMashiach, the image and the likeness, will either confirm your obedience to the Father, or he will deny your obedience to the Father. Hallelujah. Let's see. Let's go to 1st Yehukanan. 1st Yehukanan chapter 3, starting with verse 1. It says, see what love, what ahab, the Abba, the Father, has given us, that we should be called the children of Elohim. For this reason the world does not know us, because it did not know him. Beloved ones, now we are children of Elohim, and it has not yet been revealed what we shall be. But we shall know that when he is revealed, we shall be like him, for we shall see him as he is. Hallelujah. So when we see him, when he comes, we will be like him. Hallelujah. We will receive that esteemed body in the resurrection. We will receive an incorruptible body. Hallelujah. We will be like him, for we shall see him. Everyone having this expectation in him cleanses himself as he is clean. Everyone doing sin also does lawlessness, also breaks the Torah, also breaks the law. And sin is lawlessness. Sin is the breaking of Torah. Sin is the breaking of the law. And you know that he was manifested to take away our sins. And in him there is no sin. Everyone staying in him does not sin. Everyone sinning has neither seen him or known him. Hallelujah. So, when we see him, when we be as he is, we will receive a new body in the resurrection. Let's read more about this in 2 Corinthians chapter 3. Hallelujah. Praise YaHuWaH for his revelation, for his resurrection, for his power. His testimonies are true. His word is pure. In chapter 3, we're going to start in 2 Corinthians chapter 3. Verse 16 reads, and when one turns to the master, the veil, remember I said that Yahushua is like the veil, but when one turns to the master, when one turns to the Mashiach, the veil is taken away. Now YaHuWaH is the Ruach. He is the Ruach HaKodesh. There's not three, Remember, Yahuwah Eloheinu, Yahuwah Chad, Yahuwah our mighty one, Yahuwah is one, Yahuwah is the Ruach, and where the Ruach Yahuwah is, there is freedom. And we all, as with unveiled face, we see as in a mirror, the kabod, the esteem of Yahuwah, are being transformed into the same debuth, the same likeness, from kabod to kabod, from esteem to esteem, as from Yahuwah the Ruach. Therefore, having the service, even as we receive compassion, we do not lose heart, but have renounced the secret ways of shame, not walking in craftiness, nor falsifying the Dabar Elohim, the word of Elohim, because Yahushua is the word, but by the manifestation of the truth, recommending ourselves to every human conscience in the sight of Elohim, and indeed our Tomuz, our Bashar, has been veiled, and has been veiled, and those who are perishing, in whom the Mighty One of this age has blinded the minds of the unbelieving, so that the enlightening of the Bashar, of the Tov News, of the Kabod of Mashiach, the esteem of Mashiach, who is the Demuth Elohim, again and over and over and over, he is the image, he is the Demuth of the invisible Elohim. It says that he is the Demuth Elohim in the Aramaic right here. Demuth Elohim does not shine on them, for we do not proclaim ourselves, but Mashiach Yahushua the Master, and ourselves your servants, for the sake of Yahushua. For Elohim said, let light shine out of darkness, is the one who has shone in our hearts for the enlightening of the knowledge of the Kabod Elohim, the esteem of Elohim, in the face of Yahushua Mashiach. Yahushua Mashiach, his face is the Kabod Yahuwah, the esteem of Yahuwah. The esteem of Yahuwah, the word of Yahuwah, the likeness, the Demuth, is made flesh. And so we have this treasure in earthen vessels, so that the excellence of the power might be of Elohim and not of us, being hard pressed on every side, but not crushed, being perplexed, but not in despair, being persecuted, but not forsaken, being thrown down, but not destroyed, always bearing about in the body the dying of the Master Yahushua, that the life of Yahushua might also be manifested in our body. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Now, let us go to the book of, let's go to 1 Corinthians now. So we're in 2 Corinthians, we go back to 1 Corinthians, and we're going to read in chapter 15, and we're going to start in verse 49. So 1 Corinthians, chapter 15, verse 49. And as we have borne the Demuth, the likeness, Demuth in Aramaic. So as we have borne the Demuth of the earthy, we shall also bear the Demuth of what is in Shemaim, of the heavenly. And this I say, brothers, that flesh and blood is unable to inherit the reign of Elohim, neither does corruption inherit incorruption. See, I speak a secret to you. A lot of translations says a mystery. It speaks a mystery, a secret to you. We shall not all sleep, but we shall all be changed in a moment, in the twinkling of an eye, at the last trump, not the first trump, but at the last trump. For the trumpet shall sound, and the dead shall be raised incorruptible, and we shall be changed. For this corruptible has to put on incorruption, and this mortal to put on immortality. And when this corruptible has put on incorruption, and this mortal has put on immortality, then shall come to be the word that has been written. Death is swallowed up and overcoming, which is found in Yeshayahu 25, verse 8. And, O death, where is your sting? O grave, where is your overcoming? Which is in Hosea, chapter 13, verse 14. And the sting of death is the sin, and the power of the sin is the laws, the Torah. Because the Torah gives a revelation of sin. Because Yohanan says that lawlessness is sin. That breaking the Torah is sin. Hallelujah. So now, let's go to the book of Yohanan. Let's go to the book of Yohanan. So we know that Yahushua, the image, the likeness, and he became flesh. He went through the torture stake. Now let's read in chapter 17 of YaHuWaH, verse 1. Yahushua said these words and lifted up his eyes to the Shemaim and said, Father, the hour has come. Give kabod, give esteem to your son, so that your son, your Ben, also might give kabod, esteem to you. because YaHuWaH is one. As you have given him authority over all flesh, that he should give everlasting life to all whom you have given him. And this is everlasting life, that they should know you, the only true Elohim. So Yahushua proclaims that Yahuwah is the only true Elohim. And Yahushua Mashiach, whom you have sent, I have given kabod to you. I've given esteem to you because he is the kabod of Yahuwah. Remember, Ezekiel says that he saw the kabod of Yahuwah. I have given kabod to you on the earth, having accomplished the work you have given me that I should do. And now, give kabod to me. Give esteem to me with yourself, Abba, Father, with the esteem, the kabod, which I had with you before the world was. See, Yahushua tells the Abba right now. He says that he had this esteem with the Abba before the world was. Restore it. We know that at the mighty right hand of Yahuwah in the beginning, that image, that likeness that was used to make Adam, that image and likeness transcends time and space. It was at the right hand of Yahuwah's one with Elohim that image and likeness was referred to over and over and over by the Nabi'im, the prophets, as Yahuwah, the Malach Yahuwah, hallelujah, the Dabar Yahuwah, the Demuth Yahuwah, the Yad Yahuwah, the hand of Yahuwah, the likeness of Yahuwah, hallelujah, all these things, hallelujah, are said about our Mashiach. Yahushua is Mashiach. His name means Yahuwah saves. And he says, now that he's about to go through the stake, this is the portion right before he goes through the stake, to give him this kabod again. And surely he has received it. He sits at the right hand of Yahuwah Elohim, according to the Tehillim. He did not see corruption. He was resurrected. Now he sits and is elevated, hallelujah, at the right hand of the Abba in the Shamayim. But he says, and now give esteem to me, give kabod to me with yourself, Abba, with the kabod which I had with you before the world was, because he was the kabod Yahuwah that appeared, hallelujah. I have revealed your name. Listen to this. Yahushua is talking about his Abba now. He says, I have revealed your name to the men whom you gave me out of the world. They were yours, and you gave them to me, and they have guarded your word. You see how Yahushua mentions all these things in tying into the name of Yahuwah. He says that I have revealed your name, and they have kept your word. They kept your debar. He revealed the name because he manifested the name of the earth by being the right hand of Yahuwah, being the image and likeness of Yahuwah, going through the state and going through the resurrection. Hallelujah. He revealed the name. Hallelujah. And now he has received that esteem again, being the kabod Yahuwah, being the esteem of Yahuwah, the demuth Yahuwah. Now let's go to Revelation chapter 1. Revelation chapter 1. Hallelujah. Yahuwah's word is amazing. There is no word like our Elohim's word. And we give him praise forever and ever and ever because his word is going out into the whole world. Revelation chapter 1. And let's see, I'm going to start in verse 8. It says, I am the Aleph and the Tau, beginning and end, says Yahuwah, who is and who was and who is to come, the Almighty. I, Yahuwah, both your brother and co-sharer in pressure, in the reign and endurance of Yahushua Mashiach, Messiah, came to be on the island that is called Patmos for the word, for the Dabar Elohim, for the word of Elohim, and for the witness of Yahushua Mashiach, who is the word of Elohim. He's the word of Yahuwah. I came to be in the Ruach, in the Spirit, in the wind and breath, on the Yom Yahuwah, the day of Yahuwah, and I heard behind me a loud voice as a trumpet saying, I am the Aleph and the Tall, the first and the last, and write in a sefer, write in a book what you see, and send it to the seven assemblies of Asia, to Ephesus, to Smyrna, to Pergamos, to Thyatira, to Sardis, to Philadelphia, and Laodicea. And I turned to see the voice which spoke to me, and having turned, I saw seven golden lampstands, and in the midst of the seven lampstands, one like the Ben Adam, one like the son of Adam, dressed in a robe down to the feet, and girded about the chest with a golden band, and his head and hair were white as white wool, as snow, and his eyes as a flame of fire, and his feet like burnished brass, as if refined in a furnace, and his voice as the sound of many waters. Hallelujah. And in his right hand he had seven stars, and out of his mouth went a sharp two-edged sword, and his face was as the sun shining in its strength. And when I saw him, I fell at his feet as dead, and he placed his right hand on me, saying, do not be afraid. I am the first and the last and the living one. And I became dead in the sea. I am living forever and ever. Amen. And I possess the keys of Sheol, death, of the grave and of death. Write therefore what you have seen, both what is now and what shall take place after these. Hallelujah. When it says, one like the son of Adam, the word Demuth appears. One like the Demuth of Adam, the Ben-Adam, dressed in a robe, hallelujah. His head and hair were white as white wool, as snow, and his eyes as a flame of fire. His feet like burnished brass, as if refined in a furnace, and his voice as a sound of many waters. Now, this same image, this same Demuth, appeared in the Tanakh, in what has been called the Old Covenant, in the book of Daniel. We go to the book of Daniel, chapter 7. Daniel, chapter 7, starting in verse 13. And it reads, I was looking in the night visions and saw one like the Ben Enosh, like the son of Enosh, which is Aramaic for man, coming with the clouds of the Shamayim. And he came to the Ancient of Yomim, to the Ancient of Days. So the Ben YaHuWaH, the Ben Adam, the likeness and the image, the similitude of the son of Adam, comes to the Ancient of Days, who is YaHuWaH. We see this picture also in hand, behold, nail, behold, seeing the similitude of the man twice in the one name of YaHuWaH, that the Ben Enosh who approached the Ancient of Days, hallelujah, and they brought him near before him. And to him was given rulership and preciousness and a reign that all people, nations, and languages should serve him. His rule is an everlasting rule which shall not pass away, and his reign that which shall not be destroyed. As for me, Daniel, my ruach was pierced within my body, and the visions of my head alarmed me. Hallelujah. Now, let's go to the book of Daniel, chapter 7, which we will see where this image and likeness of Yahushua has the eyes like fire, the head and hair like white wool, hallelujah, the feet like burnished brass. We see this in the book of Daniel chapter 10. But that son of Enosh, that son of Adam, Ben-Adam, Yahushua says that he is the Ben-Adam over and over and over. He is the son of Adam throughout the Bashar, throughout the glad tidings. He announces himself as the Ben-Adam, who is the image and likeness, hallelujah. In Daniel chapter 10 and verse 5, it says, then I lifted my eyes and looked and saw a certain man dressed in linen, whose loins were girded with gold of ephahs, and his body was like beryl. And his face was like the appearance of lightning, and his eyes like torches of fire, and his arms and feet like polished bronze in appearance, and the sound of his words like the sound of a crowd. And I, Daniel, alone saw the vision, for the men who were with me did not see the vision, but a great trembling fell upon them, and they ran away to hide themselves. So I was left alone when I saw this great vision, and no strength remained in me, for my comeliness was destroyed in me, and I retained no strength. But I heard the sound of his words, and while I heard the sound of his words, I was stunned, lying with my face to the ground. And see, a hand touched me and set me trembling on my knees and on my palms of my hands. Hallelujah. The same experience happened to Yaakov in the book of Revelation. He saw the appearance of the son of Adam, the Ben-Adam, whose eyes were like flames of fire, and he fell down at his feet, and a right hand touched him. And here Daniel sees this image in what is called the Old Covenant, and what happens in the Tanakh and Daniel? He falls before the one whose eyes are like flames of fire, as if one dead, and a hand, a Yod, the hand of YaHuWaH, reached down and touched him. The same hand that fell upon Ezekiel, the same hand who lifted him up by a lock of his hair into visions in the Shamayim. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Now, if we look at the name of YaHuWaH and reflect upon his name, and we remember what the Tallinn all all say, YaHuWaH saves for his great namesake. And we remember what Malachi, what he says, that in the latter days, in chapter 3, verse 16, that YaHuWaH is going to listen and hear and record a book of all those who are meditating upon his name. The word for meditating or thinking upon his name is chabash, and chabash means to weave, as in weaving a basket, as in meditating in a way where you're taking different strands of the same puzzle and putting it together in a fashion where it can hold substance, right? Where it can hold weight. And what we are doing is we're tying all the pieces of the scriptures together and weaving them together and bringing the name of YaHuWaH and manifesting the name of YaHuWaH in a way that we understand what it means when he says that he is the beginning and he is the end. He is the Aleph and that he is the Tall. That he is the hand behold, nail behold. That he is the manifestation of deliverance and salvation. And he saves with a mighty right hand. This is the revelation of Yahushua Mashiach. This is the true glad tidings that those who are sent forth, the apostles and the prophets, proclaimed. This is the undeniable truth of the scriptures. That in the beginning, Yahushua had the esteem, had the kabod with Elohim. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with Elohim. And the Word became flesh. It became Bashar, and it tabernacled amongst us. Hallelujah. And we saw his kabod, the esteem of only brought forth Ben from the Abba, from the Father in the Shemaim in the heavens. Hallelujah. Because it says that no man has seen Elohim, but the only brought forth Ben did declare. So when YaHuWaH created Adam in his likeness and his image, and he made you, my brother, my sister, to be a vehicle of the Ruach HaKodesh, and we know that at the last trump we shall be changed, and when we see him, we will be like him. Our goal in this journey is to turn away from our sins, to profess the name of Yahushua, that YaHuWaH delivers, profess the resurrection, profess the Torah, profess the laws that govern the life of mankind, that we should keep the covenant of YaHuWaH Elohim, because his laws were given for man. Hallelujah. And we are pressing forward to be made in his likeness. We have died to sin, died to the flesh. We have borne the earthy, the form, the demuth of the earthy. And the scriptures say that we will bear the demuth of what is in Shamayim and who is in Shamayim, but the Abba, the Almighty, the Father, whose great name and great fame has gone forth to the four corners of the world, who saves with a mighty right hand, and who is resurrected and given life to the Mashiach, the Word made flesh, Yahushua, hallelujah. Yahushua is the Mashiach. His eyes are like flames of fire. He is Aleph and Tall. He is the Word of YaHuWaH. He is the hand of YaHuWaH. He is the kabod, the esteem of YaHuWaH, the likeness, the demuth of YaHuWaH, the selma, the image of YaHuWaH Elohim, hallelujah, according to the Torah, according to the Nevi'im, the prophets, according to the Brit Hamishah, the renewed covenant writings. And we praise YaHuWaH for the revelation of being able to clearly see and clearly have the testimony of the true essence of Mashiach. Hallelujah. That he is Elohim. That he is the Word. And this is our belief. And this is our testimony. And we know that he who we bear testimony of is true, and he is coming, and he will return, and his return is near. And we profess his coming, hallelujah, and we profess his way, the way of the Master Yahushua HaMashiach, and we die to our flesh so that we may live, and we may live in him who created, hallelujah. He was the Word that created all things. He is the Word that manifested the worlds. He is the Word that stretched out the Shamayim, the heavens of the heavens. And this is our belief, and this is our testimony, the same testimony, the same message that was given to Moshe and Moses, that was given to Yashayahu, Isaiah, and all the Nevi'im, the prophets of old, and Dawid, the beloved, who wrote most of the Tehillim, the Psalms, and the Brit Hadashah was written by the apostles. This is the message that Elohim has appeared many times through his demuth, and that it was the brought forth son, the Ben YaHuWaH, who did declare. profess the truth of YaHuWaH Elohim and his reign and his Mashiach, and repent from your lawlessness in this wicked generation, in this adulterous time in which we live. Turn away from your image that you have created, and the lust of the flesh, and the pride of life, and all the desires that are of it. And turn to YaHuWaH Elohim, for the lust of the flesh, and the lust of the eyes, and the pride of life, they are not of the Abba, but are of the world. And the world is going to pass away, it's going to burn into the fire. But those who do the will, that those who do the word, the Devar of YaHuWaH, abide forever and ever. Yahushua is Mashiach. Hallelujah. Shalom. Shalom.